Now that we have an instance of Langflow up and running, we can start by creating our very first chatbot. We can create a new flow either by clicking on New Project or Start Here. From this pop-up, we can select one of the existing templates, but because we want to learn everything there is to know about Langflow, we'll start with a blank flow. The first thing I like to do is to set my project name. Let's click on this drop-down, then Settings, and let's call this My Chatbot. Then, optionally, we can write a description, but I'm just going to keep this blank. Let's save this, and let's continue to create our first chatbot. At the moment, we're unable to execute this flow using Playground because we don't have any output nodes. So let's start by adding an output node. Under Outputs, let's add the Chat Output node. Now, let's have a look at nodes in Langflow. When you hover over any node, this little pop-up will be displayed, and this gives you a few important options. We can click on code to view the source code behind this node, and if we wanted to, we could make changes to this node. But for this series, we won't make any changes to the source code, so let's close this. Next to code, we will find the Save button. If we made any custom changes to the source code, we could save our custom node by clicking on this Save node, and this component will be saved so that we can reuse it in the future. So if I click on Save, we will be able to find our custom nodes under the saved space over here. Also, if we go back to the dashboard, we can see our custom components by clicking on Components, and here we can see that custom chat output node. I'm going to go ahead and delete this, as we won't be customizing these nodes ourselves. Let's go back to our flow, and let's continue looking at these other options. We can click on Duplicate to create a clone of that node, or we can click on these three dots to see additional options. We can delete a node by clicking on Delete. Or, if we have a look at these options, we can also go to Advanced Options, and this will show additional properties that are available for this node. We can choose to show or hide any of these properties by using this toggle over here. Let's close this pop-up, and let's have a look at what else we have. Another important feature is this docs link over here. If there are any documentation for this node, you can simply click on docs and that will navigate you to the Langflow documentation for this node. If we have a look at the node as well, we have two inputs called message and sender name. And next to this field, we have this input over here. And if we hover over it, we can see all the different nodes that we can attach to this input. We could also simply click on this field and enter a message like hello world, or we can click on this button to enlarge this input field. Let's click on finish editing and let's actually run this in the playground. We can use the playground to test our flow, and at the moment we're unable to input anything since we don't have an input node, but we can still test the output by clicking on this button. And we do get hello world back from AI. We can change this text from AI to anything else by changing the sender name. Let's change this to Sam. In the playground, let's test this again. Let's clear this chat by clicking on this eraser button. Let's run this. And now we get hello world coming back from Sam. Now let's fix this input box. We can do that by adding a chat input to the canvas. And if we look at the chat input node, we can hard code a message in this input. Alternatively, we'll actually get the input from the user. And we can also set the sender name. Let's leave it as user for now. To keep things simple, let's simply pass the output of this input node to the message input on the output node. Let's run this in the playground. Let's clear the chat. And you will now notice that we are able to enter text. So let's enter something like hello. Let's run this. And of course, we simply get hello back from Sam. We can also personalize the name of the user by changing it in the sender name. I'll simply enter my name. Let's run this in the playground. Let's clear this. And let's say hello again. And this time it's my name that's showing up. So it is useful to know that we can personalize this type of information using Langflow. Now, at the moment, we are simply passing the input from the user as the output in this output node, which is not ideal. We want to pass the message from the user to an AI model, and it is the response of the AI model that we want to return in the chat output. We can do that by breaking this connection, so simply click on this line and press delete on your keyboard. Let's add an LLM by going to Models And here you have a wide variety of models to choose from, including open source models. The choice of model is really up to you, but to keep things simple, I will be using the OpenAI models during this series. Another excellent alternative to OpenAI are the Anthropic models, and Anthropic does give you $5 of free credits when you verify your account. The choice is really up to you. So I'm going to add this OpenAI model to the canvas, and let's pass the input from the user into the input of the model. And we can then pass the response from the model to the message on the chat output. Let's have a look at the other attributes on this OpenAI node. For the model name, I'm going to leave it as GPT-4o, which is the latest and greatest model from OpenAI. It's also very fast, inexpensive, and the results are absolutely fantastic. We will get back to the API key in a second, but let's have a look at temperature. Temperature is a value between 0 and 1. 0 means that the model will be factual and it will stick to the prompt. 1 gives the model free creative control, so it might deviate from the initial prompt, but the results could be very creative. Let's change it to a value like 0.6, which is a sweet spot between being factual and creative. Now let's have a look at the API key. So in order to make use of the OpenAI models, we need to generate an API key. You can generate a key by going to platform.openai.com/api-keys. Simply register your account, and then from this page, click on Create New Secret Key. Give your key a name like Langflow YouTube. Click on Create Secret Key. Copy this key, and then back in Langflow, you could simply paste the key into this field, but that is not recommended. Instead, we will create a global variable. We can do that by clicking on this globe, then Add New Variable. Let's give our variable a name, like OpenAI API key. Let's change the type from generic to credential, and let's paste in our API key. Let's save this, and from the dropdown, let's select that OpenAI API key. Global variables can be extremely helpful as you are able to reuse these variables in different nodes. You can also view and manage your global variables by going to your profile, settings, then global variables. Here we can see all those global variables that we created, and we can delete them by selecting them here and clicking on delete. Or we can create new global variables from this screen. Let's go back to our flow. We can already test this out by clicking on playground. Let's clear this and let's send our chatbot a message like hello. And look at that. We do get a response back from our AI model. And we've just created our very first chatbot. But we can greatly improve this chatbot. At the moment, it doesn't have any personality and it doesn't know its own name. Let's ask it, what is your name? And you will see this response saying, I don't have a name and you can call me assistant. But I want my chatbot to understand that its name is Sam and respond in a much friendlier tone. We can change the behavior of our model by using prompt templates. Let's do that now. Let's make some space. I'm going to break the connection between the chat input and OpenAI. Let's go to inputs. Let's select prompt and let's add this to the canvas. Now we can use these prompts to change the behavior and improve the responses from our models. Let's click on this field to enter a prompt. Here we can prime the model to respond however we want it to. So let's enter, your name is Sam. Respond to the user's messages with humor, kindness, and emojis. So we can check and save this. And let's connect this prompt to the input on the LLM. So we do have one problem though. We need some way of injecting the chat input into the prompt as well. Because at the moment, it's only this text that will be passed to the model and nothing else. And if we try to connect the chat input to this template input, this will completely override our prompt template. So this will simply take the message from the user, pass it through the prompt to the model, which is not what we want either. So let's have a look at how we can inject the user input along with our prompt. I'm just going to re-enter the prompt again. So what we can do to inject dynamic values into this prompt is to use prompt variables. At the bottom, we can see that prompt variables can be created with any chosen name inside curly brackets. So let's tell our model that this is the user message, and we can create the variable with curly braces, and let's call it message. We can also see the variable popping up down here. Let's click on save and close, and now you will notice that we have this message input on the prompt node. So let's connect our chat input to this message input. This effectively means that all of this text will be passed, and then whatever the user enters in the chat box will be injected into this variable. Now let's test this out in the playground. Let's clear this and let's have a look at the responses now. And look at that. Now we are getting emojis back at the much friendlier persona. Let's ask it, what is your name? And this time it knows that its name is Sam. Now let's have a look at adding memory to this chatbot. To show the benefit of memory, let's do the following. I'm going to tell my chatbot that my name is Leon. So initially it says, okay, hello there, Leon. Nice to meet you. But if I ask it, what is my name? It simply can't tell me. And that is because although it seems like we have a conversation with conversation history here, each request to the model is an individual request and the model does not have a view of the conversation history. So it cannot recall my name. We can use memory to keep track of the conversation history and inject all of these messages into the prompt as well. Let's have a look at how that works. So to add memory, go to helpers. Let's add the chat memory node and let's have a look at this node. Here we can specify the number of messages that should be passed along in the conversation history. By default, it's only the 5 previous messages. We can increase that to say 20 messages. For the sender type, we can leave it on machine and user, which simply means both sides of the conversation will be tracked and injected into the prompt. Now, the session ID is extremely important. This needs to be a unique value, for instance, the username or some unique identifier. And this will allow us to swap out different conversations. So let's say we wanted to go from Leon to Kyle, we could do that as well. So let's leave it on Leon. So what this chat memory will do is record our conversations in this Leon session ID. So now we just need some way of injecting the conversation history into this prompt as well. We already had a look at how we can inject additional values by using variables. Let's click on the template and let's add a variable for our conversation history. I'll actually add it above the user message and let's add some text like chat history just to tell our model what this variable is about, and it's called the variable history. Let's check and save this. Now we have this history input, so let's attach our chat memory node to this history input, but we're not done yet. If we try to run this in the playground, so let's type something like my name is Leon, and let's ask it, what is my name? You will notice that this will not work. And that is because we need to set the session ID on the chat memory node, which we did, but we also have to set the same session ID on the chat input and on the chat output. But you will notice that we don't have a session ID input on this node. We can enable that by going to these 3 dots, advanced, and here we can see the session ID. Let's simply show this. Let's save the change and look at that. Now we have the session ID available. So we could call this Leon as well, so that it's consistent with the session ID on the chat memory node. Let's go ahead and do the same thing for the chat output. Let's click on advanced. Let's show the session ID. Let's save this. Let's also call this Leon again. Now that our session IDs are consistent, let's try this again in the playground. Let's clear this. Let's say, my name is Leon. And let's ask, what is my name? And look at that. It remembered my name. At the moment, we're hard coding the session ID on each of these nodes, which is not ideal. We want to store this value once and then repeat the same value all over the place. We can do that by going to inputs, Let's add a text input, and here we can store any value that we want. Let's enter Leon, and let's now connect this text input to the session ID over here. Let's also connect it to the session ID in chat memory. And lastly, let's also connect it to the session ID on our chat output node. How useful is that? We can actually also use it as the sender name. So now whenever we want to swap between different users, all we have to do is change this name. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel.